This is a regular car
that runs on the floor. And this is the car I made. It runs on the floor as usual, but the catch is it also runs on the wall, even in ceiling. But before showing you how I build it, let's go a few months back. One day I saw my nephew was trying to drive his car on a wall. That strikes into my mind, and I thought, if I can make a drone that can fly into air, why couldn't I make a car that runs on wall? So I dived into physics and used the principle of vacuum cleaner, in which a motor creates enough suction to pull anything that comes in front of the nozzle. And if I put any barrier in front of the nozzle, it will get attached, because it creates an air seal and allows itself to stick it on the surface. And we need to find something similar but small in size. So I tested out few 12 volt brushless fan, one of which was stuck for a while in 24 volt. But when I increased the voltage a bit, the motor burned. So I realized this type of motor won't work. So I custom designed a turbine and a base, which I 3D printed. And with just 3.7 volt battery, it produced enough suction to hold it in place. Now the question is, how much weight it can carry? To test that, I attached a tray and put some weight on it until it fell down. So the total weight it can carry is around 65 gram. So we need to make our car within that weight. And to make such car, we need motors, wheels, some electronics modules, and obviously this suction motor. And to keep everything within a single surface, I designed a base and gave it to print on my 3D printer. It will take a lot of time. So in that time, I started building a sample circuit. Now the sample circuit is done. Also the base is ready. So I pulled it and attached the motor and the circuit one by one. To control this car, I designed an Android app, which worked like a charm. Everything is working as expected, but the only problem is weight. And for that, the car never sticks on the wall. It weighs 105 gram, which exceeds the maximum weight limit to climb on a wall. So I need to cut down some weight. For that, first I replace these 19 gram motors with these 6 gram motors. And replace these 29 gram wheels with 3D printed wheels, which weighs only 2 gram. Now the base weight is 40 gram. And including the electronics, it becomes 66 gram, which is still on the upper side. And we still haven't included the cover weight. To further reduce the weight, the only option is to decrease the weight from the electronics part, which currently weighs 27 gram. To reduce it, I started designing a circuit using Altium Designer. Here I used only necessary components, and to reduce even more weight, I used SMD version of these components. I'm using this software from half an year now, and it's a very professional software. Top tier companies like Philips, Microsoft, Bose, Audi, even NASA use this software for PCB designing. If you want to try this software, you can get 30% off if you follow my referral link. After completing the circuit, I converted it into PCB. And when it is done, I saved the file and went to PCBY.com. Then I entered PCB size and chose the quantity. PCBY offers stencil at very low cost, so I added stencil in my order. And after uploading the Gerber file, I placed the order. It will take 5 to 6 days to get in my hand. So at that time, I designed the outer view of the car and gave it to print. It took more than 12 hours to print. But after printing it, I realized the height wasn't enough to fit the suction motor. So I had to remake it once again. But this time, the filament breaks and the model become distorted. And finally at the third attempt, it was perfect. But we know finishing of any 3D print is not pleasing enough. So now let's see how I convert it from this to this. First, I removed all the support materials. After that, I took sandpaper bunch and chose 100 grit sandpaper to clean the roughness. Then with 220 grit paper to make it fine. And after reducing some roughness, I used water and 400 grit sandpaper to make it smooth. After that, I used filler and sanded again using 600 grit paper. After doing this process for the third time, the outer surface became very smooth and ready to apply the paint. After applying the first coat, I again sanded it using 1000 grit paper and applied the paint again. And this time it became very shiny and looks like an injection molded one. After finishing it, I added stickers to make it sporty. And after painting those wheels, the model is finally finished. The PCB package has just arrived, so I unboxed it and arranged some PCBs on a plain surface and aligned the stencil on it. Then I applied solder paste and used a card to spread it evenly on the PCB and placed all the components one by one. When it is done, then I used hot air station to solder it. After completing the PCB, I weighed it and it is only 6 gram, which is really a good thing. Next, I connected FTDI adapter and uploaded the blink program and the onboard LED started blinking. That means the circuit is properly functioning. So I attached the rest of the components with it. Then I attached everything with the base of the car. Then I attached the cover and the car has finally finished. As the build is completed, so now it's time to see how it works. It runs flawlessly on floor. After turning on the wall mode, it runs pretty well even in wall. But sometimes it struggles to climb. But in ceiling, the outcome is mind-blowing. It runs extremely well. I hope you like this video. If you like it, share it with your friends. And if you haven't subscribed my new Hindi channel, please do subscribe it. Many new DIY video is coming there. So see you in my another one. Till then, bye bye.